How do you make money on a property being sold at a 5% cap rate? What's happening, YouTube? It's Matt Faircloth. Thank you for watching Mentorship Monday. My name is Matt. My company's called the DeRosa Group, and you guys are watching a segment we have called Mentorship Monday, where people email questions to helpme@derosagroup.com. That is helpme@derosagroup.com, and I answer your questions right here on the YouTube channel for you and everyone else to learn from. So today's question comes from Dimitri, who's right up the road in Lawrenceville. Shout out to Jersey. Dimitri, welcome to Mentorship Monday. Thanks for your question. Dimitri's question is simple. It's pretty straight up, really. Hey, Matt, when investing in condos, townhomes, single-family home, duplex, people are trying to get the 1% rule and the holy grail 2% rule. That's funny. Well, anything less than 1% rule is considered not a great investment. I find the 1% rule is actually a break-even, Dimitri, and above that is where you actually make money. And as Dimitri points out, when it comes to multifamily properties, I frequently see properties at 5 caps, which means that it's yielding 0.5% of the purchase price. Not exactly correct on your evaluation, Dimitri. That's not how 5 cap works. The cap rate's not directly related to the rent coming in on a property. You can't look at just a 5% cap rate and say that's 0.5% of the percent rule. The way the 1% rule works is if you look at a property and you say it's being sold for $50,000 per unit. Okay, that could be a $200,000 property, as you have here, a $200,000 property being sold for 4 units. Okay, so that's 50 grand a door. Okay, so 50,000 a unit, if the rents are $500 per month per unit, that is the 1% rule. If the rents are $1,000 a unit, that's the 2% rule for 50,000 bucks per unit, right? The way cap rates play is I take that rent, let's say it's a 4-family rented at $500 a unit, that's $2,000, and then I deduct out expenses, and let's say they're at a 50% expense ratio, meaning that for every dollar that comes in the door in rent, 50% of that rent comes back and goes towards expenses. The other 50% of the rent goes towards net operating income. Okay, that means I'm making $1,000 a month or $12,000 a year in net operating income. That's not profit, that's not cash flow, that's NOI. That NOI then needs to go pay my debt service, and behind that is what I make in my cash flow. But you take that NOI and you divide it by the purchase price, that gives you the cap rate. So if you're at a $12,000 per year NOI, and mind you, this is a super, super simple equation. I need my whiteboard to really do this the right way, because I could factor in vacancy and all that kind of stuff. But bottom line is you do all that and you're at 12,000 over 200,000 bucks in purchase price, which yields a cap rate of 6%. That would be the cap rate on that deal, okay? If you're at that's a 1% rule deal. Now that's also assuming your expense ratio is 50%, okay? But you have to factor in expenses when you factor in cap rate, my man Dimitri. Now, bottom lining, getting all the way back to your question, because that's not even what you asked. You didn't even ask that, but you did your math. You did your math wrong, and you're interposing cap rate and the 1% rule. And I wanted to correct you because a lot of people do that. So, your question is, how are properties sold at a 5 cap? Why would somebody even pay a 5 cap for a property? Well, here's the answer to your question, Dimitri. Number one is that it's a crazy high multifamily market. Just bottom line, it's just a ridiculously overpriced multifamily market right now. And a lot of times people are selling stuff at 5 caps because they can. And people are paying 5 cap on property because they have money to put to work somewhere. Maybe they're doing a 1031 exchange. They just have money burning a hole in their pocket, or they went to run to the back of the room guru seminars, and they think they're going to make lots of millions of dollars in real estate by buying a 5% cap rate property. Who knows? Whatever it is, there's a lot of people buying multifamily right now. That's reason number one why properties are priced at a 5 cap, is because there's buyers at 5 caps, right? But the way that you can actually make money on a property at a 5% capitalization rate, there are a couple different ways. Number one, let's say it is a strip center, okay? And it's at a 5% capitalization rate, and the tenant pays, and it's a triple net lease, meaning the tenants pay all the maintenance, all the property related expenses, like real estate taxes and insurance, everything like that. Tenant pays all that stuff, okay? You as the owner really only collect rent, which goes back towards your debt service. That's it. If you're doing a deal like that, a 5 cap might work. because you don't really have any expenses beyond just your debt service on the property. What the tenant pays in rent goes right into your pocket. So maybe the 5 cap works out that way, okay? Because the expenses are very, very low in properties like that. Maybe it's a new construction apartment building and the expenses are very, very low and proven to be low and not 50% ratio, maybe they're a 30%. Those are ways that a 5 cap may work, okay? Because if you're borrowing money on the property and you've got whatever you had to lay down, you're making a cash flow and your NOI minus your debt service, maybe that cash flow is ample for you, right? That's one way, is low expenses. More likely, what you're doing is something called a value add play. And like 90% of people that are buying apartment buildings are all talking about doing value add. Value add is a fancy way of saying, I'm gonna go do stuff to the property which enables me to raise my rents, okay? Or enables me to increase the income of the property, which almost always means raising rent, okay? You could do things to reduce expenses and everything like that. But in big apartment buildings, the way the game is played is you go and say, okay, I'm gonna go put a new flooring and paint new kitchens and new and a new playground and all this other kind of stuff, which we do. The DeRosa Group does all that kind of stuff, so I'm familiar with it. You do it and you charge more rent in exchange for the improvements that you made. And that's called a value add play, where you can take a property that's performing at a 5 cap now, and by increasing rents to cover all those improvements that you're making, you might make the property end up at like an 8 or a 9% capitalization rate. And then you're making some real money, right? So that is why people buy properties at a 5 cap. Really, savvy investors buy property at 5 cap is because they see that they can invest in the property, make changes, come and tweak and make it a good deal. I hear a lot of people say, you don't buy a good deal, you make a good deal. So that's why people really buy 5 caps, because they see something they can, like some way they can pluck the hair off of it to make it a palatable property. And it might not be now. So that's really and truly, Dimitri, why people buy 5 cap rates. This is a long-winded Mentorship Monday, but there's a lot of good nuggets in here. Thank you for you guys that stayed to the very end to hear all this. Thank you, Dimitri. Don't forget, help me at DeRosaGroup.com with your Mentorship Monday questions. Appreciate you guys and have a great and profitable week.